Okay, yes. Okay, so let's start with today's class. Okay, so let me share the screen. Yes. Yeah, can all of you see the screen where there's a Word document with heading typical G codes yes, and M codes? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Clear, no? Really visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, yes. Okay. So, in the last class, I just took up only a few things where I just told about two or three G codes. Okay. So let me, in today's class, let me tell some of the codes that is required for today's programming. And then let us go on to the to how to write a program, okay, for a simple problem. So before we go into that, let us see. So as I told you in the last class, G codes, that is G00 or G01, G02, this will, is going to have some meaning with respect to the movement of the tool. Okay, please remember that. Anything for movement of the tool in any direction, at whatever is the speed, and whatever it is, okay, all that things will be coming with respect to G codes. Okay, anything that has got operations with the machine, right? Like, say, for example, spindle has to start rotating, okay. Tool has to be changed, okay, right? So such things will be taken care by the M codes, okay? Will be taken care by the M codes, okay? So yes, in the last class, I told you about G00, which is the first G code, which means rapid traverse. That means once when you give this G00, once when you use it in the program, the tool will move from the current position to the required position, that is the coordinate that we have given, okay, in the with the maximum speed, what are the machine capable of, okay, right? And also it will travel in the shortest distance. That is, so if I have, say for example, I have to travel from here to here, okay. Right, so the tool will also travel like this only. It will not bother about, even if there is any rectangle or any workpiece in between. No, it will not see anything. Or the tool will not move like this from here to here and then from here to here like it will go round about. No, it will not do that. It will not go like that. It will go in the shortest distance, okay, from starting point to ending point, okay, right, with maximum speed, okay. So this we will use only when we are very confident that there is no object or the workpiece in between where the tool is going to travel, okay, only, and where there is no machining taking place. So only in that particular time we'll use the G00. Anyway, we'll see this, okay, and G01 is for linear interpolation, so the tool can move in a straight line from, so we have to give the ending coordinate, right? So over there, and with G01, we have to give at what speed the tool should also move, okay? The tool can move horizontally, vertically, or in inclined line also, right? Then G02 is for circular interpolation in clockwise direction, okay? Right, in clockwise direction. So if the tool has to move in clockwise, has to move in clockwise direction, right, from top left to bottom right, over here the arc is shown, right? So in this case, we are going to use G02. That is, the tool is going to move from top left side to bottom right side, okay? But if it is going to go the other way, that is for G03 in anti-clockwise direction, then it is going to be like this, okay, where the tool is going to move from right side, the tool is going to go in anti-clockwise direction, the movement, Whether the tool is going to move upwards or downwards is not a concern. Whether the movement of the tool is going to be clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction is what we'll have to see. Right. G04 is for dwell. That means in between the operations, sometimes we need the operation, I mean, the tool should not have any functioning. That is no operation to take place. And that is for about for a few seconds, 5 seconds or 10 seconds. So how do we stop that? Still, the spindle may be rotating. Okay, so during that time, we'll use G04. Okay, yes. Okay, and movement of the tool. So movement of the tool we require is that whether the tool has to move in what units are we going to measure? Okay, in inches or in metric. If you are going to give in inches, then we are going to use G20. Okay, and when we are going to use metrics, that is in mm system, we are going to use G21. Okay, so G01, G02, and all, we are going to tell that the tool is going to receive this command and the tool is going to start moving. But in what measurements? One unit, two unit, what unit? Inch, metric, what is it? So we have to first define what is the unit to the machine that it has to follow, right? Okay. Then G28, okay. G28 is the automatic return position, or also called as the home position. Okay. It is also called as the home position. Okay. Yes. Can you see this paint screen now? Hello?
Yes.
Yes. So say, for example, if we have the tool over here, just a second. If we have the tool over here, okay, right? Then this has got some coordinate. Actually, what we have over here is, this is going to be, this is going to be z-axis, and this is going to be our x-axis, okay, right? So from here we have what, 0, 0. And this will be minus z axis and plus x axis. Okay, so tool will go in the machine frame, that is in the machining center. Okay, there will be one place over here where it is called as the home position, where the tool from here, once we give G28 command, it will go here. And this is the place where the tool will be changed. Okay. The tool has to be changed only in this home position only, nowhere else. So we have to take back this tool to its home position, okay, which will have U and W as the coordinates for only for home position. We'll use U and W, nowhere else. Okay, just like if you remember your FEM, okay, where you have global coordinates and local coordinates, two coordinate system in the same frame. Okay, similarly like that only over here also we have. Only for home position, instead of mentioning as x0, z0, if you mention x0, comma z0, then it is going to become this particular place where we are nowhere going to change the tool. Even in, if you remember in the machine shop, used to retract the tool from the workpiece, then stop the machine, and then the spindle, and then you will change the tool, right? Same thing we have to do over here also. Okay, only thing, it's a CNC machine. So the tool has to be taken back to its home position, which we call it, which will use a G28 command. Yeah. So yes, that is for G28. Okay, G32, 40, and all those things we will see later on. Once we go on, once we need those particular codes, I'll explain you that particular time. Let us not remember all the codes now itself. It will be a little bit difficult to remember also. Right, okay. And yes, what is it? Let me see, just a second. Okay. Yes, so next we'll go to M codes. Okay, just a moment. Okay, so let's get back. Okay, yeah. So now let's go to yeah. There is other things that we'll have to come. One is for so next is about the G70, okay, and G71. Okay, that is for we'll be using this for turning operations, right? So we have done turning operation in machine shop using the lathe on the lathe machine, okay. So and then if you remember, we will we would have removed the outermost material that is present onto the circumference by repetitive machining operations. That is the turning. We'll give about 1 mm or 2 mm depth of cut, and the tool will move along the length of the if I have the workpiece over here. The tool is going to be moving from one end to another end, okay, and we come back, we give a next depth of cut for another 2 mm, and then we go back and so on. So this cycle repeats, right? Okay, so to do that we are going to use the rough turning code, which is called as the G71, okay, right? And next thing is that we have is the for the finishing operation during turning. Okay, for turning, first what you will do is that you have to remove overall 5 mm. Okay, so in that case we will be using 1 mm, then 1.5 mm depth of cut with we'll do the turning operation little bit rough. Then when you go for finishing operation, almost 4.5 mm we have removed, another 0.5 mm we have to remove. So during that time, what we'll do is in a lathe machine, we will increase the spindle speed, and the tool will move. The depth of cut for the tool will be very small, and also the tool will move at a slower pace. Also, right? The tool movement will also be will have a very small incremental value. For that, we'll be using the G70 code. Okay, G70. Syntax for this we will see in the program. Okay, and yes, and then we have. The next thing is that, okay, we have defined it G21 as metric units, Then the next thing that we have is that G98, feed per minute. Okay, feed per minute. Okay, right. So this is going to be in context with the tool movement. Okay, so it is going to be feed in mm. So if you use G21, okay, in mm, mm per minute. Okay, so feed is going to be in mm if we are going to use G21. Okay, and beside that, if you use G98, for the feed rate, what is the unit? It has to have the length in units and per time, right? So length can be in mm or inches, and time can be per minute or per revolution. So if you are going to use it per minute, then we are going to take you make use of G98. Or if you're going to, if you want for every revolution of the workpiece, the tool should move 1 mm, then we have to go for G99 in that particular case for every revolution. So mm per revolution, right? So like that. Yes. So now let's see about the M codes, okay, which is going to deal with the spindle start, stop, coolant on, off, and so on. So first thing is that is for we have sir, yes.
Sir, do we have to remember all the codes, or is there a reference chart or something?
No, we have to remember all the codes.
Okay. And then right. These codes differ for every software, or is the same?
What can you come again, please?
Sir, are the codes similar to all the softwares, or does it differ for every software?
No, most of the codes are same for on any software.
Okay.
99% it is same. In some softwares, even between some softwares, all the codes are same. Because all these codes are based on FANUC system, FANUC coding system. So the software will use the FANUC coding system. Okay, yes. These are all the FANUC codes.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Yes. So yes. So okay. For M codes, we have one is the major thing that we'll have. So anywhere we want to stop the program, we'll use M00. Right. Generally, we don't use it for our labs. Okay, as of now. Okay, then we have optional program stop, that is in between the program whenever we want to stop the program and check the machining how it has been happened, and then we can continue with the next line. So in that case we'll be using M01, and then program end is for M02. Okay. Yeah, next, this is very important, M03, the spindle, whether we want the spindle to rotate in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. So even if you remember the lathe machine in machine shop, we can rotate the spindle, that is the chuck, in clockwise direction as well as anti-clockwise direction. So for clockwise direction it is M03, anti-clockwise direction it is M04. Okay, then spindle stop, we want to stop the spindle. Okay, so then we'll use M05. Right, so this spindle stop we'll generally use when we are going to do the tool change. Okay, we want to change from one tool to another tool, so during that time we'll stop the spindle. Right, so then M06, that is the code that is the command for changing the tool. So whenever we want to change the tool from tool number 1 to 2 or 2 to 3, we have to use this code M06. And M08 is for coolant on, M09 for coolant off. Okay, and M30 is for the end of the program and reset to start. Okay, right. So at the last line in all the programs, we'll have this M30. That means this is the end of the program, and it can restart right from the beginning of the program for the next workpiece to be pulled in. Right, so yes, we have sub program call and sub program end and all those things which we will not use now. Okay, right. So yes, any doubts with this? Any doubts? Hello.
No sir.
Right? Okay. So let us go to one of the program. Okay. So CNC program. Let us go to this. Let's take one simple program, which is this particular diagram. Okay. Right. Can you see this diagram? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. Okay. So the first thing that let me take this diagram to the paint shop. So I just need to write certain things. One is the coordinates for this. So please remember, the horizontal axis is the Z axis. And the vertical is indicated by X. Okay. And we will generally have this particular 0, 0 over here at the center. Okay. Right. Okay. Now, the first thing that we have to do is that before we write the program, is that find out what are the coordinates that we require to write the program. So in the program, we have to make use of X and Z coordinates. Nothing but in graph sheets, we will write X comma Y, right? So here we are going to use X comma Z. Okay. So what are the values for each one of these positions here, 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 and so on, right? So first, let us make a note of that. Okay. Right. So first thing is 0 comma 0. Okay. That will be point number one. So I'll just put point number one over here. Point number two. Okay. What is the height? Here it will be height is 20.
Oh.
Okay. And height,
10.
Yeah, 10, I'll come to that. Yes, I'll come to that. I'll come to that. Okay. And X is 20, Z is 0. Okay, it's at 0 comma 0 only. Sorry, 0. So, yes. So now in X, why are we taking the diameter itself is the question. So in the programming, we have another setting whether we are going to give the X values in the form of diameter or radius. Okay, there is one setting for that. Okay, in the software. So based on that is the X value that we are going to give. Generally, it will be with the diameter only. Default, always we are going to take the diameter values only. Okay. If at all, if you say no, I'll give it in anyway, we are going to machine on only one side. So we are going to get a cylindrical surface and I'll give only the radius values, then we'll have to change that setting. Is that clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. So this is coordinate number one. Then this point, we need this point for machining. So number two, then the third point is over here. Right. So I'll write it here. Number three. So what is the value? Now the height is 20. Okay. What is the distance of point from Z? From
minus
0,
20.
0. Minus 20. Right. Okay, minus 20. Right. So next is number four. Number four is over here. Right. So the value of four is how much? X is 40. Okay. Then our distance is how much? Distance is minus 20 only. From here, 0 to 20, it is going to be here only. So the distance is minus 20. Okay. Right. Next, point number 5. Yeah. Point number 5. Yeah. What is the height? 40. right? And the distance is how much? Yes, minus 45.
Minus 45.
Okay. Here I have told you whether we are going to take incremental values or absolute values. Okay. So for that also there's a setting. Okay. And we will always take it for the absolute values. That is any distance that we measure, any point that we measure, we'll measure it from the starting point. That is 0, 0. So if I have to reach 0.5, it is going to be 20 plus 25. That is 45. Okay. Right. Okay, next we have point number 6 over here. Right, point number 6, the value is how much? Height is going to be 60. That is the x value. Okay, distance is going to be minus 45. Right, so the next thing is number 7. So here for 7, how much we need? 60. Okay, distance is how much? Z value is going to be 20 plus 25 plus 30. So 45 plus 30 minus 75, correct? Right? So I will always recommend that you please write this table always. This is going to be very, very helpful. Okay. Any problem that is given, put a table like this, point, then second column X, third column Z. Okay. For each one of these points, write the coordinates in a table. This is very much essential. Okay. And the same thing should also be written in the record also. So in the record, onto the left side page where you have the blank sheet, write the diagram neatly with all the dimensions. Okay. Mention the billet size or the raw material size. I'll come to that. Then after that is going to be this particular table. Okay. And then there is one more thing, that what are the tools that you are going to use? Okay. The tools used should be mentioned. What is the tool number 1? What is the tool number and all those things? I'll tell that. Okay. Right. Fine. Any doubts still here? Any doubts? Right. Okay. So let me go to the program then. Okay. Okay, so yes, before going to the program. Okay, now when you start any lathe operation on a lathe operation in a machine shop, you collected the workpiece. What did you do next? Yes. After you collected the
tool workpiece, setting.
What?
Tool setting.
Tool setting. Then anything else?
Length.
What? Somebody said something. What did you do after collecting the workpiece? What did you do?
To measure it.
Yes, you will measure the diameter and the length of the given workpiece, right? So same thing is what is required here also. We need not have to measure, but we have to give what should be the size of the raw material. Okay, what should be the size? So if I need to machine this part and get it as the final output, then what should be the size of the raw material?
More than this.
Yeah, what? What, Roshan?
It should be more than this, the actual.
Yeah, how much? So you need in length, now the overall length is 75. Okay. Now you need at least to have the length to be at least 85 or 95, correct? Length should be for that value. Diameter? Diameter how much?
65, around 80, 70.
Because the maximum diameter is 60, you can take up to 65, right? At least so much, isn't it? Okay, right? Right, so this is also required. So this we will call it as the billet size. Yeah, this we'll call it as the billet size. Right. So now let's go to the program. Okay, so the first line in your program will be on this software is to insert a percentage symbol. Okay, insert a percentage symbol. Next line, you will write capital O, that is the standard code. That means it indicates the program program number we have to first write, okay, which should have a capital letter followed by four digits. Okay, followed by four digits. So we can have it over here, since it's program number one, we can also have it as 0001. Okay, right. So the next thing is that this billet size, we can have it. We need not have to write it in the program, but we should know what should be the billet size that we have to feed it onto the software. Okay, so here, okay, it's 60. So let us make it as 65 is the maximum diameter. Okay, and the length, let it be over here as around, let us take it as 90. Okay, 90 mm. Okay. Start Z at 2 or not, we'll see what is this start Z at 2 later on. I'll explain that. Okay, as of now, my way of writing the program will be start Z at 2, not 0. I'll tell you what is this 2, 0, and all those things. Right. So now we are very clear with the diameter and the length. Okay, now what is this start Z at 2? Okay, so. All right, I'll come to that later on. Right, so first thing, okay, now how do we start the program? So the first thing will be like this. I'll just take it up over here. It's going to be like this. When you write the program, you know, on a sheet of paper or on the software. So first line, it is going to be the percentage symbol, then capital O, program number with which will carry four digits. Okay, then we are going to first indicate the line number, okay, which is written as N, capital N. Now in all these cases, everywhere all the alphabets in the program is capital letters only, no small case letters at all. Okay, right, so it's better when you write the when you type the program, keep your keypad caps on. Okay, so now N05, we can also start with N01, but we generally go in terms of 5, 10, 15 and multiples of 5. Because if you want to make any minor changes, we can insert it easily. So N05, G21, G29. So what is G21? We are going to say all the measurements that we are going to do in this program is in metric units. G99, okay, I'm going to take it as the feed for the tool should be in per revolution. So mm, we have already told metric units, mm per 99 we have used, so it is going to be mm per revolution. Okay, right, so anything that we give, it is going to move by whatever the mm that we mention per every revolution. Okay, right, right. So next line, okay, N10, G28, X0, Z0, okay. Sorry, it should not be X0, Z0, here it should be U0, W0, okay, right. So we don't know where the tool holder is there exactly in the machining space, okay. So we will first push it to the home position, okay. We are giving the command, the tool holder, whether it's carrying the tool or not, it has to go to the home position. So we are going to use G28, U0, W0. Next, once the tool holder has reached the home position. The tool has reached its home position. Okay, then we can go in for tool change. M06, which is the code for tool change. And how do we mention, specify it? Okay, so for that, the syntax is M06 space capital T 0101. Always the tool number for every tool, rough turning tool, finish turning tool, grooving tool, right? So every tool will be having, will be given with 4 digits. Okay, so whatever the tool that we're going to use first, we are going to give it as 0101, T0101. Okay, right? Generally over here, we are going to make use of rough turning tool, okay, for 0101, T0101. Okay, so next line is that, okay, tool we have changed. That means the tool has been fixed onto the tool holder. Now we have to start the spindle, okay? But the tool is still now in the home position only. The tool is still here only. The spindle has not yet started to rotate. So we have to start the spindle to rotate. So M03, which is for the spindle to rotate in clockwise direction. Okay. At what speed should it rotate? At what speed should it rotate? So capital S will denote the speed. Okay. And followed by the number. Okay. So we will give 1000 or 1500 RPM. So we just mentioned 1000 or 1500. It is going to take it in RPM only. Yeah. And then simultaneously in the same line, we are going to give M07. Okay. That is for coolant on. Actually, there is one code missing. Okay. M07 is for mist coolant. Okay. It, the coolant will be sprayed onto the workpiece in the form of a fine mist, okay? Whereas M08, if you use, it'll just pump the fluid like a flood, okay? It'll just, a very large quantity of coolant will be sprayed onto the workpiece. So we can use M07 or M08. Here we require only M07, that is enough, because we are only going to do turning operation, okay? Right, so the next thing is that, now, till now, what have we done? Tool is in the home position. Spindle has started to rotate. Okay, now we have to get the tool first closer to the workpiece. Closer to the workpiece. It shouldn't touch. Okay, what is the raw material size? Raw material will be so much. So this diameter is how much we had given. I think 60, how much we had taken? Okay, 65. Yeah, 65. Okay, and the length is how much? Length we have taken as 90. So this height, okay, over here, this height from the axis is going to be 65 mm. Okay, right. So if the tool is going to come and land up over here, very close to the workpiece over here. Okay, see, there's a clear gap. I have not touched the tool. The tool doesn't touch the workpiece at all. So it should be, what should be the value over here? Let it be 66 or 67 mm. Let it be 67 mm in X value. Okay, Z value is going to be 0 or 2. Let's see that. Okay. So here we are going to give 67. I'll just give it as 67. I'll also give Z2 over here. Why Z2? I'll tell you. Now the picture comes whether we are going to give Z2 or not. Okay. Now, my way of programming is a little bit different. Okay. I will usually have Z as 2. What is this Z2? I'll tell you now. All right. Okay, so let me go back here. Right. Okay, so let it be as it is. Just take a different color so that you can understand it better. Okay. Now, what did I say? This is the z-axis, and this is the x-axis. And this point, that is the axis over here for the tool, is the 0, 0. Okay, is the 0, 0. Now, what will I do is that I will take extra 2 mm this side. See, I will take at least 2 mm when I take the workpiece. So workpiece surface, this particular surface will not be placed over here. I will place it such that the workpiece starts from z is equal to 2. Z is equal to 2. 2 mm or 3 mm or even 5 mm also I will take. Okay, right? So why am I doing this? I just come to that. So after you fix the, after you measure the workpiece and then you fix the tool onto the the tool post, and you fix the workpiece onto the spindle. Yes. Then you start the machine. What do you do next? Hello?
Feed rate, sir.
What? Feed rate. Feed rate? Any
basing operation.
Which one? Which one?
Basing operation.
Yes, exactly. Facing operation. Right? So when you're going to do the facing operation, if the length of this workpiece is 100, okay, and you're going to remove, let us say, for example, 5 mm in facing operation. So how much do you have remaining as 95? That is going to be the remaining length after facing operation. Yes or no? Right. Okay. Now, for example, this diagram that has been given. This diagram that has been given. Okay. Is it before facing or after facing?
After
facing, right? So after facing, this length for the first step should be 20 mm, the second step length should be 25 mm, third step length should be 30 mm, right? So this is after facing, right? Okay, so what I will do over here in that case is that, okay, whatever is the program that I'm going to write is with respect to after facing. So if you look at the coordinate, what is point number, let us go to point number 3, okay? How much it is? X value is 20, Z value is minus 20. So from here 0, 0 to this, it is going to be at a distance of 20. So when you measure it also, this particular length will also be 20 mm. Yes or no? Okay, and where is it starting to count? From 0, 0. Right, so even this starting phase will also be will be at 0, 0. Measuring is also from 0, 0. So everything that I need to do is just go as per the dimensions given in the diagram. Why am I doing this? I'll tell you now. Why is it?
How does the computer know where the origin is?
Okay, right. So how does the computer know where the origin is? Now, the moment we give the length of the workpiece, okay, the moment we give the length of the workpiece, okay, this X and Z coordinate is variable. It can go anywhere onto the in the machining area. I can even have it like this also. I can even have it here also. So that this one I can call it as, one second. Here I can call it as 0, 0 in this particular place. Okay. But what we'll do is that to identify this one only, okay, we are going to say where is the starting point of the z? Where is the starting point of the z? Okay. And usually it will always be at the right hand side. Okay, not onto the left hand side. Okay. Right. One more thing for this, for your question. One second. Yes, it is with respect to this z. Okay, so yes, if you note here, we are going to give this start z at either a 0 or 2. Okay, so this has got two meanings. One is for where the workpiece is going to be situated. Okay, so the right hand side will be the z is equal to 0. Okay, right, that is just a imaginary. So that what will happen is that what it is going to do is that the moment we give the billet size, how much have we given the billet size, the length of the billet, 90 mm. Okay, so for 90 mm we have given it. Okay, for 90 mm we have given it. We need some space for the chuck to hold. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Right, so from here onwards, what it all, can we move the chuck horizontally?
No sir.
No, the chuck is going to be fixed, it can only rotate, right? So usually what it will do is that the moment we give 90 mm, so it will measure from here, from the chuck end, from here 90 mm, and fix this point as z is equal to 0. Is that clear? Yes or no?
Oh, okay, got it.
Got it? Did you get it now? So that is how it is going to, it's only an imaginary axis, right? So it is going to measure how, where should it be located, based on from the chuck. It is going to calculate from the chuck, right? Okay. Yes. So now let me go to this. Okay. Now let me go to this. So I was explaining about if I have after facing operation, if I have the measuring for the programming, it's going to start from 0, 0, and the tool is also going to start counting only from the 0, 0, and we want the same dimensions to be written, or the coordinate values to be written in the program also. So in that case, the coordinate x and z coordinate should meet exactly onto the workpiece surface after facing operation. After facing operation, so that I'll get this one exactly as per the dimensions given. Now what about if I don't give like this? Say for example, I'll just get back that picture so that you'll be able to understand. So let me get it over here. Okay, now yes, okay, now let me take up this, say for example, yeah, and write the, sorry, okay, now this is going to be the 65 mm diameter, length is going to be 90, and I will say start z at 0, 0. So where will it be? It will be here. This point will be 0, 0. Right, now let me assume that this distance is 2 mm. I'm going to do facing operation. So this particular portion is going to be removed, right? Now, what do I have next after facing operation? Sorry, I will have it like this. I'll draw it with a different color. So I will have like this. I will have this particular portion. Still, the raw material will be like this. Only this particular portion, okay, which is left blank over here, is going to be removed, facing operation. So what is now going to happen? What is going to happen? Is the material starting at 0, 0 after facing?
No.
No, it is not going to start at 0, 0. Okay, now the material is not going to start at 0, 0. Now, after facing operation, I want this length to be 20. So what should be the coordinate? Tell me for this particular point.
Minus 22, sir.
Minus 22, right? So you have to remember every time how much did you remove the material during facing operation. Yes or no? Correct, no? You took up what? 20 plus this facing length as 2 mm, how much ever you have faced, right? So 2 mm or 3 mm, we have to add that every time in where?
Z coordinate.
In Z coordinates. Right? By mistake, in any one of the coordinates, when you write the program, if you don't add this facing length, what will happen? Will this be 20 mm if I don't add that 2? You said minus 22. If I, instead of giving minus 22, I'll give only 20. What is the actual length then?
18, sir.
18. Is it correct? Are you getting the final output to the required dimensions?
No, sir.
No. Right? So this is very, very important. So to avoid this confusion only, that is why what I am going to do is that in my programming and always, the way that I do is that I'll give the material length as billet everything, but I will tell the computer that the material is starting at Z is equal to 2 mm outside onto the positive side of the Z axis. So this particular area, I'm keeping it specially for facing. I'm going to keep it specially for facing. Now, where is after this, what is going to happen? Where is the material starting after facing? Now it is going to exactly coincide with the axis. Right? Now, when I want to find the coordinate for point number 3, how much should I give? Did you get my point? I'm going to face it off. Now the material is going to coincide exactly with the x-axis. Okay, with the x-axis, right? And now what should be this length? It is going to be the same as the given dimension only. I don't need to add anything or I don't need to subtract anything. Is that clear? Hello? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Clear? Is that clear?
Yes,
all
sir.
Of you? Right?
Yes, sir.
So
this
is the reason why I am taking start Z at 2 mm. Start Z at 2 mm. Okay, that means after 2 mm inside this, So when I give start Z at 2 mm, what is going to happen is that this red color axis line that I have written, x and z, will be placed from the length of the object, from the length of the workpiece, 2 mm inside, from here 2 mm inside automatically. So this I am going to keep it for facing. Now see, automatically after facing, what is happening? Axis, origin, and starting of workpiece is going to start exactly at the same point, 0, 0. I don't need to give any allowance, plus or minus. I don't need to do any changes in that. Right? I can directly go with the dimensions that is given without any confusions. Without any confusions, I can go. I don't need to worry whether I should add that value or whether I should subtract that value. No, everything has been avoided. Okay. Right. So when I prepare this table, I don't need to worry. Should I give any allowance or should I not? Not at all required. Put as per the dimensions only. Find the coordinates over here for every point. Put that same values over here in the respective column, x column, z column. Finish. That's all. Right? Is that clear? Right? Okay. Now let me go back over here. Okay. Now, so we are given till here. So I'm going to start with, I'm going to get what? G00, X67, Z2. Or I can write it as Z1. Let me write it as Z1. I'll tell you why. Okay. I'll put it as Z1. So let me go back over here. Okay, right. Okay, so let me remove all these things. Just give me a second. So let me remove all these things. Okay, everything is getting erased. All right, so let me do one thing. Okay. Let me remove this. Okay, and let me remove this one also. Okay, let this be here, no problem. Okay, now what do I want? I want the tool to to travel from its home position to a particular value. How much have I given? Z is equal to 67 and x is equal to 67 and z is equal to 1. That means the tool is going to come here and be situated in this position. So this particular value, okay, the height is how much? So I mean the tool tip, okay, the tool tip is at a height of 2 mm. So that is 67. 65 is the diameter of the workpiece, plus above that 2 mm gap is there. So the tool tip will be at the height of 67, Z1. Okay, so if I am going to give Z1, what is going to happen? So if I'm going to give Z1, see what I've given, the allowance I've taken extra as 2 mm, but the tool is at Z1. That means already I have over here, let me change the color. Yeah. This portion just inside the workpiece, right? It is not going to touch, but see this 1 mm gap. 1 mm gap. So tool will directly travel in at the fastest rate since I've used G0, 0 to the required coordinate, which is X67, Z1. So it will be here, this particular value. Yeah. Right? This particular value. Right? Now, what is the first operation that you do in the lathe machine? What is the operation? Yes,
facing,
yes. So facing, how do you do actually? Can you just tell me? in which direction the tool is traveling.
Along the axis.
Along the axis, which axis?
X-axis.
Along the x-axis. That means we just want to reduce the length of the workpiece. So now, just imagine, now if I just move the tool in this particular direction, right? This 1 mm is removed, no? Yes or no? Correct, no? What do you do in facing? Actually, the tool is moving from the circumference towards the center of the workpiece, correct? Yes,
yes
or
sir.
No? Correct, no? So what is happening?
Yes,
the tool is moving from the circumference to the towards its center. Towards its center. Okay. So already I have placed here. Where is it? It is 1 mm inside. So I have to just move the tool directly downwards. That's all I have to do. So automatically this 1 mm has been removed, no? Clear? Yes or no? Yes or no, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Right? So this is the reason why I did not give as over here X67Z2. I did not put this Z2. I put it as Z1. So where is it coming and landing up over here directly 1 mm inside? Right? If I have given Z1, it will be here. Instead of that, I'm just bringing it here. I'm skipping one step. Why should I write every step just to waste time? Okay. Right? So what is going to be my next line? So my next line, I will write it here. N26. Actually, we should give 30. Okay, I'm just writing it. Okay. G01. How should the tool travel? Tool should travel only in a straight line. What is the code for the tool to travel in a straight line? G01. Okay, from where should it travel? It is already at 67. It should just travel straight downwards until it meets the x value becomes zero. But in facing, will you go only up to the center or a little bit beyond that?
Little bit beyond, sir.
Little bit beyond that. So if I go beyond this, what is the value of x?
Little more than 67.
Little more than 67. If I put 68, 69, it will be here, ma.
So half of 67. More than half
of 67. Half of 67 will be here. 35. See here, 67, 66, 65, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 0.
So minus something.
Yes. It should be minus 2 or 3 mm. So we'll give over here G01. Tool should move in a straight line. So G01, X minus 1 or 2 you give. Okay, whatever you give. Space. Okay, Z is equal to 0. And give the feed as 0.2. Okay, tool should move in a linear line, linear moment. Until it meets the coordinate x z is equal to minus 1. That means somewhere over here. Okay, and still z is 0. That means, z is equal to not 0. Let it be 1. Yes, tell me.
So that's what I'm asking, Z1.
Z1, okay. Because it has to travel here. Okay, it will be here. Okay, Z1. And at what speed should it move? Right? I'll just put it for some particular speed. Facing, you will not do too quickly, right? Little bit slower only. So F is equal to 0.2. Okay, that means 2 mm per revolution. 0.2 mm per revolution. Because what have we defined? Feed is in what units? Mm per revolution, right? So I've given what? Feed 0.2 mm per revolution. Is that clear? Yes or no? Okay, clear with this line? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Right? No doubts? Okay, fine. Now I'll go to the next step. G00x, I'll put it as 67. Z is equal to 0, not 0, sorry, 1 minute. Z is equal to 2, okay, and then N28, G is equal to G00, okay, G00 again, X is equal to 67 again, and Z is equal to 0, right? Okay, and yeah, now what are these two lines? Let me tell you. Right. Now, what is this line? Okay. Now, the tool is now exactly where. Let me change the color. Now, the tool was over here. Sorry, too many lines, so you can't see it clearly. I'll just erase this. So, the tool is going to be here. Right? X is equal to minus 1. And Z is equal to 1. Now, this material I have removed for 1 mm, facing has been done. Now, I want to move this tool back to this particular height over here. Right? So, is there any material in this space? Hello? Is there any material?
No, sir.
No, sir. So I can use G00 command. Okay, tool will move in its highest speed and to this coordinate where it should stop. So what is the coordinate over here? 67 heights. Okay, and this is Z is now at 1. So I will take it outside that. So Z value will be 2 or 3 I will give. Is that clear? So that the tool will move in this particular direction. Right? Yes or no? Clear? Any doubts?
Isn't it more time efficient if you cut during that stroke, sir?
I didn't get you. Can you tell me once again?
As in, instead of going back away from the material, can you just cut during that back stroke?
So you're telling that let it go back in the same straight line in the upward direction, right?
Give feed and then cut the other 1 mm, sir.
Give feed. How can you give that feed? Because I'll just tell you, wait. Now already
that's how we also do in machine shop.
Wait. Already your tool is over here. Yeah, I'll just put it in red color so that you can see the difference. Now we have the tool over here. Will you take the tool back straight like this?
No, sir. Give feed so that it goes towards the left and then you can cut the rest of the 1 mm.
That means you want to push it inside the workpiece and then go back like this?
No, probably while giving minus 1 as X, sir. Go fully down, sir, as in minus 67 or something like that. And then... During the reverse stroke, cut the other 1 mm.
Okay, but we don't do that in that particular manner, no? Because in lathe machine, what happens once you go beyond the half of it, the remaining half is also removed, no, automatically.
Yes, sir.
Correct, no? So you're not going to do any kind of machining over here as there is no material, first thing. Second thing is that if the diameter is bigger, then your traveling time is going to increase for such a distance.
Okay, sir.
Isn't it? So that's why we retract it back. We take the tool back, okay, towards initial portion. So the same thing only.
What we were taught in machine shop is that it's more time efficient if you cut both the front and back. Sir.
Okay, like that's for to and fro motions.
To and fro, yes, sir.
To and fro motion, right? So yes, you can do that, but generally no. In CNC machines, we don't do that. Okay. Generally. Write it back from here. Okay, we just take it back to its initial portion. We just take it a little bit outside. Okay, so that's why we are given X is equal to 76, z is equal to 2 over here. Okay, right?
Yes.
Now what should I, what do I need? Now the tool is over here. Let me put it in red color. Now the tool is over here. I have to get it back, this tool, to this position, new position. Previously, it was here in the green color one. Z is equal to 1. Now I have to put it for z is equal to 0. I have to just push it horizontally, right? At maximum speed, because there is no material. I am very much sure of that. Okay. So G00, X67, Z is going to be 0, right? Z is going to be 0, exactly above this. Okay, that is why I put the next line. G00, X is equal to 76, Z is equal to 0. Now what is going to happen? Now let me change the color. Okay, I'll put this. So the tool is going to be over here. Let me erase some of that. So that's, now the tool is going to be here. Okay, and I have 1 mm material that I can face it off. Yes or no? Correct, no? Yes or no, guys? Hello? Clear or not? Right? Okay, so that is why,
yes, explain
what I'm going to write after this is that n is equal to 29, G01, okay, X is equal to minus 1, okay, and Z is going to be 0, F is going to be 0.2. The same thing what we wrote over here. Same thing only thing is the coordinate has been changed. The same thing only we're writing. See the line number 26 and 29, both are same. Right? Only this value has changed. From Z1, it has become Z0. That means whatever the tool was over here at Z is equal to 1, I pushed it by 1 mm inside so that I can face this another 1 mm of material. Yes or no? Clear? Clear, guys? Hello? Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. One second. Okay, let me copy this diagram now. So again, let me write the.
So why can't we give Z0 directly?
Z0 directly. Where? In which line? Which line? Line number, please. Z0 directly, that means for
the very first line
over here. You mean to say that instead of doing it in two steps, you would like to do facing in one step, correct? Instead of removing 1 mm, then after that again 1 mm. Yes or no?
That line only,
yes,
sir.
Or no? So you mean to say directly remove 2 mm in one go, is it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay.
Instead of doing it twice.
Okay. Yes, you can do that. Okay. I just showed you how it will go on because there is one heading that I have to tell. I've explained it. I've not told the heading. Okay. Then the second thing is that how do you define? How do you decide what should be the depth of cut Let it be turning operation or facing operation. How do you decide? Now we are going to do facing operation. Fine. Okay. Now how do you decide? I am going to do. I can remove directly 5 mm, or I can remove over here only 2 mm. I cannot go beyond this. What is the criteria for that?
So Ashok sir taught us this one thing where if you have coolant, you can go 5 mm more than 2 mm per second. Or
okay.
Speed. And if you don't have coolant, you can go like 2 mm or 2 mm per stroke.
Yes. Okay.
So it depends on the coolant or.
Okay. Anything else? That is one point, correct? Okay. Anything else? It actually depends upon the first thing is that what is the workpiece material made up of? Mild steel, aluminium, right? Hardened steel, right? Or you have nickel. And what is the tool material made up of? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Correct. So this also comes into picture. Okay. So whether you're going to do 1 mm or 2 mm, okay, you can do it. Okay. The reason why I showed you it in two steps is that, see, now what we have done here from line number 25 to line number 29, every movement of the tool, every single moment, I have to give the commands. I have to use G01 or G00 or G02. Everything I have to mention, every pin. Even if I want the tool to move, say for example, in this direction, then come here. This will be the second line, then third line in the program, and again come here, fourth line. Then again go back here, then do some other operation. So for every moment, I have to keep giving this, right? I have to write every line again and again, right? So writing like this is called as without canned cycle. A program, CNC program written like this, okay, is called as without canned cycle. We will not use G70, G71 at all. Okay, this is called as without canned cycle, right? So there is something called as with canned cycle. Okay, there is something called as with canned cycle. What is that with canned cycle? Let us see. Yes, can you see this paint screen, paint that I've shared over here? Can you see that? Yes or no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, good. Okay, so now let me put this. Okay, now what is the height over here? The maximum diameter that we require is 60, but we have another 5 mm, correct? We have another 5 mm extra of material. Now, how do you remove it? How do you remove it?
Turning.
Turning, yes. Okay. So what I will do is that, see, I put this, I have put this 5 mm in separate sections, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Okay. So when you do turning, say for example, did you do directly 5 mm depth of cut for turning operation?
No, sir. No, sir.
How much did you give?
2 mm, sir.
2 mm, right? Okay. So let us assume you remove this material 2 mm, 2 mm, and later on 1 mm or 0.5 mm, isn't it? Okay. So first thing is that what you'll do, you'll put the tool below by 2 mm, Okay, what is the diameter over here of the raw material is 65. So 2 mm minus 65 minus 2 mm, how much should it be over here? 63. Correct? Yes or no? At this particular point. Correct or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, okay, sir.
So you'll bring this tool to the 63 mm diameter, x value 63. Then you're going to tell the tool to move horizontally until it reaches the end of the workpiece. Then retrieve back, that means go above and go back to its initial position here outside the workpiece. See, outside this black color line. Outside this black color line, so that the tool comes back to this position once again. Right? This is one pass. Yes or no? In lathe machine. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Then what did you do next step? Next time you went for another. I'll just change the color. Okay, next, what you do? You give another depth of cuts. You push this tool down. You got it over here. You gave another 2 mm depth of cut. Now the value is 61. Correct? And the tool starts to travel along this line. Then after that, it is going to be retrieved back. And you're going to come back over here. Yes or no? Right? Isn't it a cycle? You're doing the same turning operation, only a small change in the value. That is especially in x-axis. Isn't it a cyclic operation?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Okay. So for such things, so if I write, just imagine G codes without CAN cycle, I should write N is equal, N starting number, some number, X is equal to 65, X is equal to 63, then Z is equal to minus 75, then I have to put X is, the next line I have to put, G00, X is equal to 67. Okay. Then the next line, G00, so that the tool comes back till here. So G is equal to 00, X is equal to 67, Z is equal to 1. That means it will be here. Right? Then next time, I should give G00, X is equal to 61. Right? Okay. And then next line, G01, X is equal to 61. Z is equal to minus 75. Okay, and then it goes along this green color line. So every time I have to write like this. Should I write so many times just for the small moment? We'll go in for something called a scanned cycle. We'll go in for something called as scanned cycle. What is the scanned cycle? This is G71 is for turning operation in CAN cycle. Okay. Turning operation in CAN cycle. Okay, G71 is for turning operation. Okay, so the syntax for this is what? G71, U and the value, then R. That is the first line, the syntax. So what is this G71? It is going to take it as turning cycle. U.5, that means depth of cut every time, every pass. See how many passes we did here? Two passes. So for every pass, I will give that how much should be the depth of cut, 1 mm or 0.5 mm or how much ever it is. That is what I will give here. Then after it passes over, until it reaches over here, after it reaches over here, it has to be retracted back. By how much should it retract? 1 mm above or 2 mm above, 3 mm above, that one is the R value. Okay, G71. U is for the depth of cut for every pass. R stands for the retracting value after the cut has been performed. Is that clear? Yes or no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So in this case, what will happen if I just take up only this line?
Yes.
In every pass, it will go for a depth of cut 0.5. go for the until the length of the billets and retract by 1 mm above, come back to its initial position. Then again, it'll go by another 0.5 mm depth of cut, go along the length of the billet and retract back by 1 mm above and go back to its initial position. So this cycle will keep repeating until we stay it to stop. So this is the first line of the G71 syntax. Then the next line also will write G71 only. P is going to be 40, Q is going to be 65. It is actually P, and this 40 and 65, I'll tell you what is that, I'll tell you. Okay, right? And then it is going to be U.1, W.1. What is this U.1, W.1? Okay, this is for the finishing allowance. After you do rough turning, you did finish turning, right? Yes or no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes? So you need some material still left out, no?
Yes, sir.
After rough turning. So how much do I need? I'm telling over here, leave off from the final values, leave off 0.1 mm in both X direction as well as in Z direction. Okay, U stands for homogeneous or global coordinate in X and Z direction. So I'm telling over here, in this particular portion, let me zoom in so that you will be able to see. After final operation, what will happen is that there'll be a small material still left out like this. So what is this distance? 0.1 mm. What is this distance? 0.1 mm, which is left out for finishing operation. Is that clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right, so finishing allowance, then at what speed should the tool move? F is equal to 0.2 or 0.25, yes, you can give. That means 0.2 mm per minute. It is going to travel linearly, okay? For every one revolution of the spindle, okay, the tool is going to move by 0.2 mm along the length of the workpiece, okay, right? Now, the next line after this. So this is the syntax for turning G71, U, then depth of cut value R1, okay, retract value. Then next line, G71 again, P, the line number, Q, again a line number, then finishing allowance in X and Z directions, and speed of the tool. Okay, this P and Q will come now. P and Q is the line number, starting and ending line number. So this is a cyclic operation, right? Turning operation. It's a cyclic operation. Then it has to remove material over here, then here, then here, and then here, and then here. So the tool movement is same, no? It's a cyclic operation, correct? Yes or no? Hello? Correct? It's a cyclic operation. So what I'm going to do is that, so since it's a cyclic operation, where should it start? Where should it end? So we are going to indicate it by the line number. So for the cyclic operation, I'm going to write some other further lines. And from that lines, the starting line number and ending line number for the cyclic operation. The cyclic operation should follow the codes. And from which line number should this cyclic operation start, and till which line number should this cyclic operation end? Okay, so P stands for cyclic operation line number starting, and Q stands for the cyclic operation line number ending line number. Okay, so next line I will write N is equal to 40. N is equal to 40. Okay, now I will come to this. One second. The Yes, we have written coordinates over here in the table, right? We have written coordinates in the table, correct? Point number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and all those things. Put that in the program. Okay. Excuse me. Yeah. So line number 40. Okay. G01. Where is it starting actually? Okay. G01. One second. Okay. So here what we need is that we don't need this because this at the origin always the facing has been done in this particular case. So we are going to start from here. The tool has to start machining in this particular direction. So what is this value? X is equal to 20, Z is equal to 0. The tool has to start machining from here. Okay. So G01, okay, X is equal to 20, Z is equal to 0. Starting of the rough turning cycle. Okay, starting of the rough turning cycle is indicated by line number what? N is equal to 40. This 40 is what we are putting it over here in the value P. Okay, right? Okay, next. From here, the tool should go where? The tool should go to this point number 2. Okay, what is the coordinate over here? Okay, what is the coordinate? X is equal to 20. Z is equal to minus 20. Okay, then what is this line? It is a straight line, right? So what is the code for a straight line? G01, right? So G01, X is equal to 20, Z is equal to minus 20. Is that clear? Is that clear? Any doubts? Hello?
Got it, sir.
Got it? Okay. So next. Now the tool is over here. Let me change the color. Now the tool is over here. Now the tool has to move vertically upwards. That is, it has to reach this particular point. What is the coordinate for this? Point number, we have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, right? What is the coordinate for number 4? 40 and minus 20. X is equal to 40, Z is equal to minus 20. And how should it move? It should move in a linear line only, again over here. So for linear, it is G01. So G01, X is equal to 40, Z is equal to minus 20. Here, G01, X is equal to 40, Z is equal to minus 20, right? Then after reaching over here, where should it move? It should move in this particular direction to reach this point. So what is the coordinate for this? X is equal to 40, Z is equal to minus 45. So G01, X is equal to 40, Z is equal to minus 45, the tool will be in this position. Next, the tool has to move upwards, again a linear line G01. What is the coordinate over here? X is equal to 60, Z is equal to minus 45, right? If you look at the table, the same things we have written, correct? So directly start writing that G01 and okay. So just look at this G01 and we can go about. So one second here with the program. This is 40, 20, 40 and 20. Okay. 40 and minus 20. Here it will be 40 and minus 45. Okay. So here it will be 40. Okay, and Z is minus 45, this particular place here, right? And then it is going to be how much? 60, second, 60 minus 45, okay. and it's not going to be the end over here itself. So 60 minus 45, where is 60 minus 45 is here. Okay, we still have to reach this particular portion. Okay, so what is the coordinate over here? 60, G01, x is equal to 60, z is equal to minus 75. So N 66, G01, it's a straight line, x is equal to 60, okay, z is equal to minus 75, and that is the end of the turning cycle. So where is it going to end? This is the end, right? So we have started here and ending here. So what is the line number for this 40? Line number to attain this coordinate is how much? It is going to be 66, right? So go back over here. In Q, it is not 65, it is going to be 66. Yes or no? Clear? Are you clear with this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So we have completed the finishing operation, I mean turning operation. Okay. Now, once we have completed the turning operation, what we are supposed to do is that, okay. Okay, right. So we bring back the tool. So the tool will automatically come back over here. Okay. And now what we are going to do is that the next line, N is equal to 70. Stop the spindle, stop the coolant also. So spindle stop is M05. Okay. And coolant off is M09. Next, I'll put it as N71 for your reference. Okay, line number N71. Okay, spindle has been stopped. So next is going to be G28. Send the tool to its home position. Okay, so G28, U0, W0. Next line, N72, line number 72. Okay, M06, T0202. Right, M06 stands for change of tool. And I'm going to put a new tool inside, finishing tool. Okay. Now, after this finishing tool has been inserted, N73, okay, spindle should be started because in the previous thing, we stopped the spindle. So, M03, okay, spindle speed, S. I'll put it as, there we gave it as 1500. Now, here we'll give it as 2000. Okay. Coolant on, M07. So spindle will start rotating in clockwise direction at a speed of 2000 RPM. Coolant will also be switched on. Next line, N74. Okay, N74, what I will do is, I'll go for G70. Okay, and I will give P is equal to 40, Q is equal to 66. Okay, and one second. Feed is going to be 0.1, or we can do 0.15. Okay, one second. Let me check the syntax for that. Yes, okay, that's all right. Yeah, so for finished turning, okay, what we did over here for G71 is for rough turning. You have something called as finished turning. Let me go back here. What's the page number? Okay, right. Okay, what is here for G70? Finishing cycle. G71 is stock removal in turning cycle. Okay, so if we have to finish it, we have to give a smooth finish. Okay, So we will be using G70. Okay, the syntax for that is G70. Give again, it's what? It is a cyclic operation, right? Again, the tool has to move in the cyclic operation only, right? And what is the depth of cut and all those things? We have already defined it in G71. We have left out how much? 0.1 mm in length, 0.1 mm in diameter, right? So that 0.1 mm, it will automatically remove. Okay, so all we need to give is what is the finishing and ending line for the cyclic program. Okay, so that is why P is equal to 40, Q is equal to 66, which is the starting and ending line number. And feed, I'll give it as very small, 0.1, because there we gave 0.2. Okay, right, little bit faster rate, the tool is going to travel linearly. Over here, the tool will be traveling at a lesser speed. If you remember in machine shop, when you did the finishing operation, your spindle speed will be higher and your tool will have a very small depth of cut, and also you will move the tool at a very small at a relatively lower speed. Okay, that is what is this. So after this, the next line is in 75. Okay, the in 75, what we'll do is stop the spindle, so M05, stop the coolant, M09, then N76, send the tool to its home position, G28, U0, W0, right? Okay. And then what we have is the end of the program. So here the program will end at 77. Okay, by ending the program M30, right, then the next line will be a percentage symbol. Is that clear? Any doubts? Hello?
Sir, can't we write M codes and G codes in the same line?
No. First, let me ask you one question. When you're going to do facing operation, yes. Okay, you start the spindle and then move the tool, right?
Yes, sir, yes.
Isn't it? If you do both of them together, then there's every chance that the tool will damage the workpiece.
Okay, sir.
Right? Is that clear? Yeah. Yes. Any doubts? Anything else?
No, sir.
Any doubts? No doubts? Okay. Clear, no? Right? So, what I want you to do is that, okay. So, this is how we write the program. This is one of the CNC program for a simple step turning operation. Stepped bar. Okay. Right? So in this, I've explained you what is without CAN cycle and what is with CAN cycle. So what is this CAN cycle? What we use over here, G71, G70, all these are codes for CAN cycle. Okay, all these are codes for CAN cycle. Okay, right. Okay, so yes, will you copy down this program now? Hello?
Okay, sir.
Right? Okay. Right? Please copy down this program, all of you. I'll only... have you all copied down this diagram? I'll keep it here. Do you want the diagram? Hello? Hello. Okay. Can you hear me? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Okay. Please copy down this program. Okay. But there is only one change that you have to do. Okay. In this program, I've used in line numbers 26, 27, 28 and all. For every line, you please write it down as in multiples of 5. Okay. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 and so on. Is that clear? Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Change the cycle numbers also, no, sir?
Yes, yes. P and Q value will also subsequently change.
Okay, sir.
Okay, right? Okay. So please copy down this program. I'll give you 10 minutes time. Okay. And also write this explanations beside that. That's also very much helpful for y'all. Okay. Please write that.
Sir, can you scroll up, sir?
Yeah, 1 second. Now?
So the heading and the diagram.
A diagram, huh? It's only you have to do the manual part programming for the given diagram. That's all. You want the diagram?
So do we get to see the simulation of this in the software, sir?
Yes, the same simulation I'll be showing it to you in the next class.
In the software, sir?
Yes, yes. I will play the, I've recorded the video already while I was working on the software. So that video recording, I will be sharing it to you all in the next class. So the same program has been written and you'll see the simulation, how it is going to go on.
Okay, sir.
Right? Yeah. So I hope all of you are writing the programs. I'll keep only the program now from starting till ending. Please copy it down clearly. Okay. Yes, copy the program. Over.
Yes, sir.
Yes, over. All of you, others?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Okay. So we'll go to the next thing. Okay. Yes, so all of you copy down this diagram. Copy down this diagram. One second. This one or that one? Okay, it's okay, no problem. Yes, copy down this diagram, please.
ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ
ಹಲೋ ಗೈಸ್, ಓವರ್. ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಕಾಪಿ ದಿ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್? ಹಲೋ,
ಸೋ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್?
ಯಾ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ.
Okay.
Only the diagram. You are going to copy only the diagram. That's all. Over.
Sir, can you show it again, sir?
Yeah, one second. Yes, you can see now. Over, guys. Over, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Others?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. So for this diagram, okay, you are going to write the program. Okay, I have showed you already one program. Okay, it's a very simple program, this one also. By keeping that as the reference, okay, you can write this program, okay, for this particular diagram. Okay, that you are going to do it. Okay, and in the next class, you are going to tell what you are going to written, as well as then whatever the corrections are there, I will make those corrections, as well as in the next class, I will show you the simulation for the program. Okay, for the first problem that we have done. Okay, and if time permits, for the second problem also. Okay, I'll show you the simulation, how to make use of the software. Okay, all these things I will show you in the next class. Is that clear? Fine?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right? And yes. One more thing, I will tell you one more thing. Okay, in the lab manual, okay, in the lab manual, okay, don't think that is the exact program. There are certain things that is not written in the program. It is not there. Now, if you observe that, phasing cycle was not written at all. Phasing operations only was not there, right? I had typed it, okay, when I was explaining it to you, right? So like that, there are differences. So please don't believe that if I get the manual and if I read only that is the end of it, the program will get executed. No. Is it clear? Right, so I want all of you to write the first program, okay, in a sheet of paper, neat sheet of paper with the diagram and that the coordinates table, okay, and leave some space to write for about 4 or 5 lines for the thereafter. There we have to write one more table where that is for the tools that is being used, okay, and then on a new sheet go for this, for the second diagram, okay, for this particular diagram. Is that clear?
Sir, can we write in a separate observation book instead of a sheet of
paper? Yeah, you better maintain it in an observation book. That's much more better. Okay. I feel that is much, much better. I would also recommend that. Okay. All of you take an observation book, start writing it off. Right? Okay. Anything else? Anything? Okay. All right. So we'll stop here for today. Okay. And we'll meet in the next class. Right?
Yes, sir.